Thursday. Everybody listening, please do me a favor. Hit that like button and make sure that you share this video. All right, what we got next? Blueface. We're going to talk about this. Speaking of, you know, record contracts and, you know, people getting jerked. Let's talk about, you know what I mean, my man Blueface, who had an interview on a Breakfast Club the other day. And Blueface, we know, is Wack 100 Cash Money West, who is the Game and Ray J's manager's artist. We got to hear this little clip right here from the Breakfast Club, man. Let's talk more about this.
Are you selling Cash Money through Cash Money?
Cash Money West.
Oh, so that is through Birdman. And
all I know is Cash Money West and Wack 100. You gotta ask Wack about the other people involved.
You ever seen your own paperwork?
Nah, I seen it, but Wack showed me. I ain't even seen the. I signed with Cash Money West. I don't really know about all the.
So Wack 100 is Cash Money West.
Exactly.
Okay. Blueface gonna be all right.
They'll be good.
I think you'll be fine.
I'm great.
This is early. It's still early though.
SamAnt, what do you think about that? SamAnt, what do you think about that? What do you think about, you know, him not really? This is what you think about that, man.
All right, so it's going to be a lot of people clowning this kid right now and a lot of people that's joking on him right now because obviously he's in a situation where he's in some deep shit. And I'm not going to do that right now. I feel for this kid. He's 22 years old. He's born in 1997.
Damn.
Got a crazy buzz, real popular. About to feel like he's changing his life, getting jewelry, getting this, getting that. And now, little does he know, he's in a situation where he's getting robbed of millions and millions of dollars. And it's just the name of the game called the music industry. Wack 100, I don't give a fuck what he told you. He is not holier than thou. He is taking your bread. I don't need to see the contract. I don't need to see the paperwork. If this is your first initial contract in the music industry and you're walking in with an industry-level contract, you're getting janked. And you're probably getting janked in touring. You're probably getting janked in your music. And you're going to come, it might be a year or two from now, where you're going to be complaining about not getting your money. Where's your bread? Meanwhile, we're going to see you with the jewelry. We're going to see you with the money. We're going to see you with the cars. All of that being leased out. All of that being rented. And in a couple years, it's going to be like, where's this kid going? That has a real good buzz, whether you like him or not. His style is weird as fuck, but he's getting a buzz. And I just feel for a kid like this at 22 because I wasn't this kid to a certain degree, but I was that 22-year-old who just knowing that my talent could, thinking that my talent would supersede the business, not understanding that the business always has to come first.
Yeah.
It's painful to see.
Yeah. It's sad. It's definitely sad, you know. You know, it's like with a business, you look at his reputation. The reputation of Cash Money is not so good when it comes to you know, record contract, even with Diddy, like we just got finished talking about. So I don't understand why people still continue, not to say anything against Wack 100. You know what I mean? That's a different, you know, extension of, you know, Cash Money, which is, I think, Cash Money West. So, he's young, man. He's young. I don't think, you know, personally, I don't think Wack's, you know, you said that's the business. I don't think Wack, you know, setting him up for failure. I think that Wack wants the best for him. But like you said, the business is the business. And different, you know, percentages are going. And the fact that he don't even know really what he signed, he's deferring it to him, is a bad sign because you should know what the hell you signed. You should know everything about that contract. And you could tell that he don't know shit about it. And that's a bad sign because that means that if Wack is not 100% honest, then he's going to be robbing his cat.
He wants his best interest. He's telling him he wants his best interest at heart because the more his interest is at heart, the more his interest is out here winning, the more money Wack's about to make. That touring, and see, what's going to happen is, and I know it, he's going to go on tour. He's going to think he has bread. He's going to get the jewelry, this and this and this. He's going to get a couple of dollars, not realizing that's in advance. He might have to pay that back and go, well, where's my tour money? Where's my money on my sales? Where's my money on my merch? He's going to realize, nah, you had to pay this right here. Nah, this cost this money. Nah, this studio time cost this. Nah, this bus trip cost this. Nah, remember when I took you to McDonald's? This cost this. Nah, this. And then you come out with this. And this kind of situation can depress an artist so bad to where they don't want to do this shit anymore. Mm-hmm. And then you look in a situation where 2 or 3 years of buzz independently can put you in a great situation where you can make a ton of money. When you think of Blueface and when he came on the scene and arrived on the scene, do you think of Wack 100? No, I just thought of him. So he got caught. He got hot on his own merit. He didn't have to sign a contract. If people are fucking with your music, you can win on SoundCloud. Most of your rappers that you love today is on SoundCloud.
Yeah.
So it's just sad to see that, first off, he felt the need to have to sign a contract in 2019. not to have this wherewithal to know what you were signing, and you're in this situation for at least 4 years.
Yeah, it almost seems like when you say record contract, it almost like, you know, should write on your forehead like slave, like really.
It is.
You know what I mean? Because it's like, you first of all, you're going into a situation where you're losing control over a lot of the things that you want to have control over, especially as an artist. You know what I mean? Automatically, you lose the control over that. So my thing is, and our thing is, to keep as much control as you can, you know what I mean? And get the money on the back end. But they want the money on the front, you know, the front end. And like you said, get all the little glamorous stuff. And next thing you know, once that stuff, because it's only a temporary joy, wears off, and you owe these companies and stuff like this for stuff you ain't even do yet. Like, you still got, it just becomes another job, another slavery at that point.
It's sad. And I'm not, like I said, I'm not getting on the kid, because if I was 22 years old in this situation with this buzz, do I do the same thing?
Probably. That's what I'm saying, right?
Probably. And so would a lot of the people and the artists out there. They would die to be in this position. And he knows that, but he's not thinking, I wish there was somebody in his circle that would have just made him go, yo, no, you got to read this contract. Read what's going on in here. Read that section. Read this, because there's language in that contract that is robbing him of money.
And my thing is, like, first, were his parents, what relation do his parents have to Wack? You know, was it just a situation where, you know, Wack just seen this guy, hit him up, and I'm managing you? Like, I would like to know that, you know what I mean, to see the nature, you know, of the relationship, you know what I mean? Because, again, Cash Money has, you know, right now, not so good track record of dealing business-wise with their artists. Just don't.
Well, in America, 18 is the legal age to do dumb shit. 21 is the legal age to do even dumber shit. So him sitting at 22, not having any sense in the world, probably needing somebody in his corner, but legally allowed to go ahead and make moves on his own, maybe not even confided, just did his thing. Wack 100 come up to a 22-year-old, say, you're going to sign the Young Money West right now. You take a Drake, Wayne, this, that. You ain't thinking about the motherfuckers asking for money 3-4 years down the line. Mm-hmm. You signing that contract. So
right,
it's sad.
Yeah, man, but you know, Wack gonna be mad at this. But anyway, it is what it is, man. We do what we do.
Yeah, I'm saying, I'm not worried about Wack. No doubt. Or anybody else. We work over here. I work out 7 days a week, ready for any situation that needs to come around. We're all good.
We're definitely, man. But you tuned into the Uncensored True podcast with your brother Old God and Sam, man. Going in today on this Thursday night. Now, everybody on YouTube, you already know what to do. Hit that like button and make sure that you share this video. SamAnt, you were telling me earlier about Lil Wayne.
Yeah.
Apparently suing a former lawyer of his for $20 million.
Well, speaking of the goddamn devil, Cash Money owns Lil Wayne. He's suing his former attorney, Ronald Sweeney, for allegedly taking $20 million while he represented Lil Wayne. Sweeney served as Lil Wayne's lawyer from 2005 through September 2018 and charged him 10%. For every deal he closed, well beyond the industry standard of 5%, Wayne claims. Now, in addition to charging Wayne for services, Sweeney allegedly tried to squeeze out more cash by seeking an additional 10% for all profits netted by his Young Money label. What else we got here? Now, Sweeney managed to pull even more funds out of Wayne by enlisting the help of another law firm for an ongoing legal battle with Birdman and Cash Money Records, as well as Universal's Music Group. The firm allegedly took 23% from the settlement with Cash Money and 15% from the latter settlement. Those percentages were added up onto the 10% Sweeney has already expected. Initial reports indicated that Universal cut a check for well over $10 million, but that amount has never been confirmed. A portion of the information released today is true. A settlement has been reached, but the dollar amount being disclosed is false. Karen Civil wrote. What is your thoughts on that?
Hey, go for Weezy, man. Go back and get all your shit.
Mm-hmm.
That's crazy, man. Another example, man, of, you know, people thinking that people don't have their paperwork together or their business mind together and trying to take advantage of them again. You know what I mean? Same, you know, situation. It's a shame it had to be an attorney, you know, to do this. But well, in any industry, you know, you're going to have, you know, people who are sharks.
Like we talk about a lot off camera, a lot of the things that we say is the most important moves you make when you get into this industry is your lawyer and your publicist. And we see why. When you have a lawyer that can sit here and basically take manager deals on top of your manager, like 10% of every deal broke. So you staring at the contract telling him this and this and this, and you taking that off the top. God damn. the crooks and savages, and they're all working intertwined. You don't know, think that this lawyer was sat there and worked with Universal and sat there, worked with the higher ups of that music industry, and they all worked that all in together. It's like the, we ain't gonna get into
right now. We're in a day where it's like self-education.
Yeah.
You know, people can learn about contracts yourself, and not to say that you're going to understand every aspect still and every single thing, but you can get clarity and you can know most of it. So by the time it does go to your attorney, you know, they can't tell you nothing outlandish to try to get anything extra, because you already know, like, look, nah, I didn't really need you to do this. He just my attorney. You know, you can't be charging me nothing crazy. It should be, you know, a relationship like that. But a lot of times these guys are so busy, they're moving and making so much money, they overstepped the little things. And I'm glad that he's now going back, you know, to try to recoup, you know, get these monies back, you know, that they try to. Goddamn crooks, man. That's crazy.
Yeah, it's wild, man. But yeah, it is what it is. Like you said, Lil Wayne deserves his money. He's been through a hell of a decade. You see the height that he went through with his music, and then the fall he went through with his negotiation. That's why Blueface needed to really pay attention to situations. But he's young, dumb, and he'll learn, unfortunately. He's probably going to learn the hard way. But you see your favorite artists now, hey, we're hot, and now they're asking for money, man. That's just the nature of the game. That's why we must stay independent. You don't need the music industry. We could put them out of effing business by sitting here doing it how we're doing it, or get a lot more control to where they need to feed us money. They're gonna have to feed us money. We got more.